I have one meeting, and then part of what that mediation in that meeting is what is the next step?
Yes.
So we just agreed on the next step, which is to go talk with Juliet's mm-hmm. parents. So I go talk with one or both of Juliet's parents, and out of that meeting, there's another step.
Yes.
So I don't have a plan that says, okay, this is how we're going to do it, and this is going to be this step, and this. They tend to fall in patterns of how mediations like this unfold.
Yes.
But it's not based upon the plan that I carry into the room.
Okay.
Everybody has been pre-mediated. They're tenderized. They're meat tenderized.
Yeah.
It's that.
And so everybody has giraffe ears on in the room at this point. Okay, so Montagues and Capulets. Your mom is here with you, right, Romeo?
Yeah.
And Mr. and Ms. Capulet, I'm very glad that you're here. Good to see you. I very much enjoyed our conversation that we had before this. And mother of Romeo, I enjoyed our conversation. I'm very touched that all of you are here and that you're willing to have this conversation. This means so much to me because of how this has affected the community and the tension and the turmoil between your families. And so to me, it's to be able to be part of this is very touching. So what I'm here to do is to support each of you that is here to be heard the way you would like to be heard by the others in the room. And so with that, who would like to go first?
Yes.
So just a second. Is it okay if Romeo goes first? Does anybody, that seems to be okay? Okay, Romeo, please, what would you like to be heard? What's the most important thing right now that you want the rest of the people in the room to hear?
So I'd like to express my feelings towards Julieta. How much there is love in my heart, and how much I would love union with her. And speaking with you, we get aware of the concern of that it might create more fight. So I wanted just to let you know that I would love to marry her.
So that's what you'd like to be heard. And is there any particular person that you would like to be sure is heard it, like her father or her mother?
The parents, yes.
The parents, okay. So I'm wondering if you would be willing to just say what you heard from Romeo.
Yep. What I heard was that you're very much in love with our beautiful daughter, Juliet. And you're really concerned that the joining together of you two will cause a lot of trouble in the families, and you want to do all you can to prevent that happening.
Ms. Capulet, do you have anything more that you would add to this, or have you also heard what your husband has heard?
Actually, no. No, because, yeah, I'm so in pain about what happened in the past. I was just sitting here and...
So what comes up for you when you hear Romeo speaking is this pain, as you describe it, this distress in you about what has happened in the past between the families.
Yes.
Am I getting it accurately?
Yes, okay. Yes.
And I would like you to have more time to speak about that. But right now, I'd like to see if anyone has anything they would like to say in response directly to what Romeo has said. And that could be from this side or it could be from this side, but does anyone want to say anything?
Yes.
Okay, let me see. So first, is it okay, we start with Juliet. Juliet, what would you like to be heard?
I really want to be heard that I love him. And I want to spend the rest of my life with him. And I also want to be with my family, and I have this deep longing that we can go to a mutual future after all the pain.
So it's these two things. Yes. That how much you love Romeo, but also love for your family, and that you want to figure out some way that you can be with him and be with your family.
Yes.
Okay. And I wonder if there's anyone here in the room that's willing to say this back to Juliet. Is there anyone in particular you would like to say it back to make sure you've been heard?
I would like my mom to hear me, and Romeo's mother.
Okay. So if you're willing to start first, Juliet's mom?
I heard that you really love him and that you want to spend your life with him and at the same time want to be with us.
And I'm tracking that you had a response before, and I want you to be heard about that. And I have a guess that you may have something that you'd like to respond right now. But if you have the space with you to hold it right now, I'd like to shift to Romeo's mom and see what she's heard, and then we'll come back to you. Is that okay? So Romeo's mom, are you willing to say what you heard Juliet say?
I heard you say that you love my son so much. And I could see it in your face also. And I could see the love also in your face.
So Juliet, have you been heard by the two mothers?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And now I would like to open this up for reaction. I would like to go first to you, and then to you, and then whoever else would like to be heard about something as a result of hearing what Juliet has said and what Romeo has said. So first, for you.
I mean, yeah. I don't know what to do, because whenever I see you, I also see the people who have been killed in our family, by your family. And when I imagine you will have children, what will come up in me? How will I feel?
So for you, there's a kind of a worry that you have about what it would be like for you in the future, seeing their children, if they have children.
And also seeing Romeo and other family members. I mean, we tried to avoid them. We didn't want to fight. Yeah, and now they are coming so close to us. And how will we deal with the pain?
So this is the worry that you have of just how will it be?
And also, I don't know if they are sorry. They never told us they are sorry.
So it's like you'd like to have some trust that there's really some care on both sides before... I'm really trying to get, before what? Before you understand, before you can really trust your daughter being with Romeo, or that... I must admit right now I'm not quite understanding what you'd like to be heard at this point.
It's about the pain. I mean, I can't just do, well, be happy and what happened in the past. It's nothing. It is not like this.
So that something that you want the pain to...
Quick time out. Yeah. Where... And then, like, just a solution, if that's possible.
What was your idea for responding?
So I would like to say what I would say. I'm scared to death. I can see the love in the two of you. And I love you. And I want you to have all the love you want in your life. And I guess it's the same for you. You want your kids. You want Juliet also to be happy. And at the same time, I don't know what to do with it. I'm really...
I feel it's really important that we join together to... I feel very sad about what's happened in the past, and I don't want that pain to just carry on and on into the future. I'd really like us to come together and to mourn all the pain and anger from the past. Let's mourn it together to prepare ourselves to move into the future where our two lovely children can live together in a happy and fruitful life.
So how do you feel when you hear that suggestion of what Juliet's dad wants?
I don't know how to do that.
Well, I have some ideas about how to do that. Right now, it's just my question to you is that something you'd be willing to try, to actually try to reconcile and bring together the families so that Romeo and Juliet can be together?
Yes, for the sake of love, I could try.
So my thought about how to do that would be a little bit different than what we're doing right now, because there are all of these things that have happened. And what I was hearing you, Juliet's dad, say, is if we actually try to heal and to reconcile the things that have happened, the people that have actually died, and all of the pain that that has stimulated in the families, that there is what you say, which is to be heard about how painful that has been, and then for someone else on the other side to be able to hear that, to where you trust you get heard deeply, and that you then get the trust that the other side cares about the pain that has been in you about that. And this may take a while. And then thirdly would be to look at where this came from. What were each of you trying to do when you did and participated in this process? And then finally, if we can get there, it would be some agreements with the families about what it would take to restore the community of these two families within the larger community.
I would like to say something with that. Yeah. Hearing this and hearing the pain I hear in both mothers and the fears and all this, I'd like to wait before to get married. I'd like to engage in this process until there is more trust in both sides, that connection, until there is more connection and healing happening. So I'd like to engage in that process and go back later to the strategy of getting married. And before that, I'd love to still be able to see her without any troubles. So that would be what I would wish for.
Thank you, Romeo. I'm deeply touched, and I see this vision of you two young people with your lives before you, leading the effort to bring our two warring families together. Wow, what a start to your married life that would be. And that would help to settle my fears for the future of you and our families.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Robin.
Thank you very much.
And then what I hear our next steps are is then the next meeting we would need to have and who it would be between, and then what we would do next. So I'm optimistic, I have confidence that we can step by step bring the families together. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Someone up on that wall is just gonna spend the night with my girl. That's what I'm talking about. That's why I'm gonna play this child. The wall between reality and fantasy, sometimes so small and not so tall. The wall between reality and fantasy, sometimes so small and not so dark.